From the Scripps Studios, this is 10 News.
Hello there, I'm Virginia Chung with this 10 News update. Quarantine passengers at MCAS Miramar say they are worried after a woman with coronavirus was unintentionally released back to the base. But that's not the only concern. So 3-year-old Annabelle, who was released from Rady with her father after testing negative, is now back there and being tested again for the coronavirus. Health officials say she is showing possible new symptoms and is back at Rady Children's. That's after a coronavirus patient in San Diego was mistakenly released back into quarantine at Miramar after being at UCSD. Officials say a labeling mix-up led to the mistake with the testing. We are told the woman now at UCSD Medical Center is doing well. High school students say a new state law is forcing them to choose between their classes and playing the sports they love. This new state law requires middle and high schools to start later. UC high school students, for example, currently have 6 periods and an optional 7th period after school. Athletes use that 7th period often as a PE elective, but with the later start times, that period is cut. Parents say they will continue to reach out to the school district to see if there's anything they can do. They're also prepared to reach out to state legislators. There's a push to cut the cost of new homes to help ease the county's housing crisis. Today, the Board of Supervisors will vote to slash the cost of building by up to $60,000 by removing some regulations and streamlining permits. Supervisor Jim Desmond says low inventory and high home prices are forcing young families to live in places like Riverside and Temecula and commute to San Diego County for work. Desmond says lowering the bureaucratic costs will lead to lower, more affordable housing in unincorporated areas of San Diego County. The San Diego Symphony's waterfront venue has a new name and an opening date. The venue along the Embarcadero is called The Shell. They recently announced that the inaugural season will begin July 10th with a celebratory 3-day opening weekend. There will be performances by actress and singer Jennifer Hudson, several Tony Award winners. Other big-name performers during the season include Smokey Robinson and the Beach Boys. The venue features state-of-the-art equipment and can hold up to 10,000 people. All right, let's talk about this weather and this beautiful sunrise behind me, Megan.
I know, yeah, it was a gorgeous sunrise this morning. Temperatures will be warming quickly underneath clear skies, near to above normal for most of the county. So mid-60s at the coast, mid-60s to low 70s inland, 50s in the mountains with 70s in the deserts. And we won't see too much change in our temperatures into our President's Day weekend. Temperatures continue to trend in the mid-60s along our coast with overnight temperatures in the 40s. While inland neighborhoods, temperatures will be mostly in the 60s with a few 70s through Valentine's Day. Most inland neighborhoods will be in the low 70s Saturday and Sunday. Virginia.
Thank you so much, Megan. For the latest news, weather, and traffic, just go to 10news.com or you can download our free app from your app store. For 10 News, I'm Virginia Shaw.